begin our story in the little town of Bethlehem. One evening in Bethlehem, four villagers were coming home from work. They were sore and tired from working the fields all day, but they stopped in the middle of the street and looked up at the sky.
You know, I'm kind of getting a little annoyed at this whole star thing. I mean, where did it even come from anyways?
I know what you mean, and I can't get away from it. It keeps me awake at night because it's so bright.
What's up with that?
Good question. What is up with that? What's up with a star that just appears out of nowhere?
Perhaps it's a sign of some kind. Something very, very good or very, very bad is going to happen. Because we all know it's so bright.
What's up with that?
Yeah, maybe it's a sign from God.
Sure, but the Bible suggests that such a star is likely to bring something special into the world. People come here to gaze upon it, to learn about it.
Because you can't ignore the fact that it's so bright.
What's up with that?
Good question. I have a feeling we'll find out. The story is still unfolding.
So while folks in Bethlehem were observing the sky and wondering, what's up with that, there were two people who had just arrived in town, Joseph and Mary. They had to go to Bethlehem because of a new tax law, even though Mary was very, very close to having her baby. They had to travel almost 100 miles with the help of a friendly donkey.
But in Bethlehem, they found that all the inns and hotels and Airbnbs were full, or cost too much. Finally, one innkeeper told them they could stay in the stables with the animals. In that stable, there was a cow, a duck, and a sheep.
Late one night, all of a sudden, the door opened, and a man, an expected woman, and their donkey came inside and started making themselves at home.
In the stable, the animals were talking. But of course, Mary and Joseph couldn't understand them. The animals just kept talking and talking to each other. But all Mary and Joseph heard was,
"Moo!
Quack, quack,
baa."
"Who let them in here?" They don't belong in a stable.
Yeah, they should be the inn with the other human types.
I mean, what were they thinking?
But all Mary and Joseph heard was...
Quack, 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 quack.
You'd think they'd just stay home at a time like this.
Yep. Or plan ahead a little so they have a place waiting for them.
And maybe they'd save up some money ahead of time, too.
But all Mary and Joseph heard was...
Quack, 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 quack.
It's just bad planning on their part.
Yeah, another typical human error.
I'd wish they'd go back where they belong.
But all Mary and Joseph heard was...
Quack, 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 quack.
Finally, the tired old donkey lifted his head. He looked at the cow, the duck, and the sheep, and he said,
"Yee-haw, why don't you try it? You try riding 90 miles on the back of an old swayback donkey like me, when you're so pregnant you can't even see your feet. You try being an expectant dad, worried about the woman you love and the child she carries. You try being me, watching every step I take so I don't jostle this woman who's just trying to get here safely. You try it."
And the cow, the duck, and the sheep felt very, very bad. And they cried out,
"Quack, quack, 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 quack.
I'm sorry. I'll offer them some milk.
I'm sorry. I'll lay them an egg.
I'm sorry, too. I'll give them some wool to keep them warm."
But all Mary and Joseph heard was,
"Moo.
Quack, quack.
Bah."
The innkeeper, who told Mary and Joseph they would have to sleep in the barn, couldn't sleep. He was pacing the floor.
"I don't know what it is, but I just can't sleep tonight. For one thing, those animals were making a heck of a lot of noise. But just when I finally got to sleep, I thought I heard something. What was that noise? There it is again!"
So the innkeeper woke up his wife, who could sleep through just about anything, and asked,
"Did you hear something? I'm sure I heard something. What was that noise?"
But the innkeeper's wife just rolled over and went back to sleep. So the innkeeper went outside to see what he could find. But the streets were empty and silent. Still, he knew there was something out there, and he wondered aloud,
"What was that noise? There it is again. It sounds like it's coming from the stables. I'll go check it out."
So the innkeeper went across the courtyard and through the stable door. There were Mary and Joseph, who had been kicked out of the inn that afternoon. The innkeeper said to them,
"I'm sorry I made you sleep in the stable, and I'm sorry I'm barging in on you like this, but I just have to know, what was that noise?" "Oh my gosh, it's your baby!"
And the innkeeper realized it had just been a newborn baby who had been cooing all along. And the innkeeper suddenly was full of love for this little baby and full of hope too. And the innkeeper said to Joseph and Mary,
"I'm going to go and tell everyone the good news of this baby's birth."
The innkeeper ran out into the streets of Bethlehem to tell everyone the good news.
Three shepherds out watching their sheep. Two of them were fast asleep, but one was staring up at that bright star in the sky. The shepherd that was awake noticed that there were some new stars shining alongside the bright star. There were lots of new stars. Then the stars started getting bigger and bigger. The shepherd realized they weren't stars at all, but angels flying toward them, getting closer and closer. The shepherd woke up the two other shepherds and pointed up to the sky. All three shepherds fell on their knees as they looked up at the whole host of angels hovering in the air. The angels proclaimed,
"Glory to God in the highest,
and on earth peace, goodwill among people.
Go to Bethlehem. There you will find the newborn king."
"What'd they say?"
"I don't know. I couldn't understand a word."
"They said we need to go to Bethlehem."
"Wait, you speak angel?
Why didn't you tell us?"
"It's just something I picked up. Wait, they are speaking again."
"Do not be afraid, for we are bringing you good news of great joy.
To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord.
This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger."
"What'd they say this time?"
"Yeah, come on, what's the deal?"
"Well, loosely translated, something like, dudes, chill out. Something big is going down in the city of David. God's son was born, and we need to check it out."
"They said all that?
That's amazing."
So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger, and the angels smiled down upon them.
Sweetly singing on.
The animals inside the stable were talking a mile a minute about the newborn baby and his beautiful cooing. But all Mary and Joseph heard was,
quack, 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 quack.
The shepherds were there too, with a host of angels hovering over them. And the angels said,
glory to God in the highest.
The newborn babes looked up at all the people and animals and angels all gathered together on that cold night and smiled.
Aww. And the innkeeper leaned forward and marveled at the beautiful sight.
Now there are wise men from a faraway country who heard about the newborn babe and came searching for him.
Followed the star that was so bright.
What's up with that?
It led them to the small town of Bethlehem.
When they arrived at the manger, they presented the newborn baby with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. The kings bowed down and worshipped him.
Sounds of a mighty eastern caravan. Hear the beat of the tambourine.
On this day, they joined with the choir of angels and shepherds to praise the newborn king.
Amen. What a joyous day it was. On behalf of Holy Family School, we'd like to say
Merry Christmas.